Welcome to MISUMI's new 19-minute webinar series. For those of you here that are new to MISUMI, MISUMI is a global supplier of configurable components. You may ask, why configurable? What is it? Configurable components solve the designer's dilemma. A designer has two choices for components, standard or custom. Standard components have limited selection and often force designers to compromise their designs. These many pluses, such as CAD, static part numbers, fast delivery, often seem inexpensive and convenient. The other choice is custom. Custom components have many drawbacks. Designers have to make the solid models themselves in all the manufacturing drawings. Purchasers too can attest to the long wait for quotes, the expensive setup charges for short runs, and the long lead times. We are forced to use custom components though, because of the flexibility. MISUMI offers configurable, which is the best of both, easy and flexible. Configurable components are easy to design with and purchase. Online, select the product geometry desired, the material and surface finish. Input the size for each configurable dimension within the range and increment shown. You'll get a smart part number, instant price and days to ship, and the CAD model. All of this configurability is available with our over 1 million components, available at MISUMIUSA.com. Now, I'll turn it over to our MISUMI engineer.
Hi, my name is Nick Waszak. I'm a product engineer with MISUMI's Motion Systems Group, and will be presenting this webinar covering sizing, selection, and a few application examples of our LX Series linear actuators, as well as a brief comparison of common motor types used for positioning. If you're interested in learning more about all the options offered in the full LX Precision Positioning Actuators line, please feel free to view part one of this webinar series, LX Series Actuators, Competitive Design. For every application, there are several considerations that need to be determined to properly select an LX actuator for an application. These factors include actuator orientation, stroke length, travel speeds, load to transport, location of the load, environment, accuracy required, and the repeatability, also known as precision. In order to help demonstrate the typical application sizing and LX actuator selection process, I'll be walking through the steps using example application. This system is a 6-actuator, 8-axis demo unit from National Instruments, built as a showcase for their NI Week 2013. To begin, isolate the first axis, the actuator which is not supporting any other actuators, and determine the application considerations for that axis. In this example, the actuator is to be in a vertical orientation, moving across 6 inches of stroke, at speeds up to 12 inches per second. The load includes a motor, clamp, and mounting bracket, requiring a positioning accuracy of 1/1000th of an inch, with repeatability of 1/1000th of an inch as well. The actuator will need to be selected for safety considerations, as well as protecting the mechanism from any medium to large debris or objects. The actuator orientation will dictate the size and type of motor used to drive the LX actuator, as well as the load ratings for the actuator and motor combination. An actuator in a vertical orientation has a lower load capability, and the use of an electromagnetic brake motor is highly recommended to prevent the load from falling during a power failure event. In a horizontal orientation, the highest load capacity can be achieved, and a brake is not required. When comparing the two orientations using the same load, a vertical actuator will require a larger, more powerful motor compared to the same actuator mounted horizontally. When sizing application requirements to select an LX actuator, careful consideration needs to be taken to select based on metric units. In this example, the 6 inches of travel translates to approximately 150 millimeters of stroke. Since this actuator will have two additional supporting actuators below it, starting by choosing a smaller actuator such as our LX20 will help reduce the load size for the base actuators. Choosing the correct actuator length will depend on whether one or two blocks are used, where an actuator with two blocks will have a longer overall length for the same stroke. You can refer to the effective stroke table to select the appropriate length. In this example, only one block is needed, so a 250mm length LX20 can be used for 150mm of stroke. Once again, making sure to convert to metric units, the example speed of 12 inches per second is approximately 305mm per second. An LX2001 with 1mm lead ball screw has a rated maximum speed of 147mm per second, while the LX2005 with 5mm lead ball screw has a rated maximum speed of 694mm per second. Because the calculated speed of 305mm per second is greater than the maximum speed of the LX2001, but still within the spec for the LX2005, the 5mm lead LX2005 is selected for this example. The next step is to verify the load size and location. For this example, the clamp is approximately 1 pound while the motor and bracket are 2 pounds together. This translates to about 13 newtons, which is well within the nearly 6,200 newton allowable static load for a single long block LX2005-B1. In addition to calculating and comparing the allowable static load, the position of the load plays an important factor in choosing the correct actuator. Overhanging or cantilevered loads can create moments or twisting forces on the carriage of the actuator, calculated by multiplying the force by the distance offset from the actuator axis. If the allowable moment is exceeded, the actuator could suffer damage. Based on the combination of the actuator orientation and the load position, there may be moment loads in as many as three directions. Each direction needs to be evaluated and verified against the allowable moment load of the actuator. In the moment specs, you'll note that the MA moment is the pitch, the MB moment is the yaw, and the MC is the roll. For our example, the center of mass of the load is located at 3 inches from the actuator along the x-axis, or in this orientation, the direction contributing to the yaw moment. The calculated moment from the weight of the load at 3 inches is 1 newton meter, which is also well within the allowable static moment of the LX2005-B1-250, thus verifying our current actuator selection so far. In order to understand the next requirements, I'll briefly explain the difference between precision or repeatability and accuracy. Precision or repeatability is the ability to hit the same spot each time. The actual position may not be the same as the commanded position, however, each consecutive motion will be in approximately the same location relative to the previous position. Accuracy is the ability to hit within the same distance from the commanded position each time. This is like hitting the same ring from a bullseye on a target. Combining both accuracy and repeatability is the best possible scenario and is like hitting the bullseye every time. MISUMI's LX actuators have two precision options available, high grade and precision grade, both of which provide excellent accuracy and repeatability. Both grades have preloaded bearings on the side carriage and the ball screw. This preload limits the backlash, pitch, and roll, and improves the overall precision of the actuators. The high grade provides plus or minus 5 microns repeatability, and an accuracy of 0.06 to 0.1 millimeters depending on the actuator size. The precision grade provides plus or minus 3 microns repeatability, and an accuracy of 0.02 to 0.025 millimeters depending on the actuator size. The precision grade actuators are select actuators that are given an additional level of inspection and testing to ensure that they meet these rigid specifications. Not only does MISUMI's LX actuator line provide great accuracy and repeatability specs, but the quality is tried and true, consistently beating out our competitor's equivalent actuator in 800-hour full-load endurance tests. When comparing the high-grade and precision-grade LX20 specs, we see that for our application example, which requires 1/1000th of an inch or 25.4 microns accuracy and repeatability, the precision grade is a better fit than the high grade due to the increased positioning accuracy of 20 microns and the very fine repeatability of plus or minus 3 microns. The final application consideration for this example is the environment. The standard LX actuator has no cover, but there is a cover type available to protect against medium to large debris and for added safety, as well as a Class 10 cleanroom rated grease for environments requiring minimal dust rays. Because this example application was designed to operate the full demo unit on the show floor, the cover type is selected for safety concerns. As each option is selected in our online configurator, the part number will be narrowed down, helping to build your final part number for your application. This process can then be repeated for each subsequent axis in your system. For example, the base actuator in a multi-axis system is typically larger than the first actuator, so here we've configured an LX30 for the base. By configuring the part online using our sizing and selection process, we end up with a final part number of LX3005-B1-F-300, which we can download the 3D CAD in order to insert it into our design. Another free online tool MISUMI offers is the lifetime verification software for the LX actuator, available at MISUMIUSA.com. To use the software, simply select your desired actuator based on your application sizing and requirements. Fill in the operating parameters for that axis. Add the mounting conditions for that load, including the weight and position of the load with respect to the actuator. And the software will provide an expected theoretical life of the actuator in the application. The calculated lifespan will be given in kilometers, hours, and years, but the recommended value for comparison is kilometers or distance. If the calculations show that the actuator may fail before the typical lifetime, usually 3,000 kilometers or less, then the lifespan values will be given in red. In that case, you may want to reconsider the actuator you've selected or adjust your application conditions. In order to provide all the resources you need to size, select, and incorporate an LX Precision actuator into your design, you can find specifications and dimensions, LX online lifetime verification software, and when logged into a free MISUMIUSA.com account, you have access to free 3D preview and downloads, as well as being able to quote and order instantly. Now that we've discussed sizing and selection of MISUMI's LX Precision actuators, let's take a look at a few additional application examples. For each one, we'll review the application requirements, the particular LX features for selection, and finish with a brief overview of positioning motor types and the applications for which they're best suited. The first example is a precision press fit mechanism. This requires a low profile design, consistent quality and parallelism, the ability to move at a low speed and handle a high moment load. The LX is a good fit for this due to sizes as small as 15 mm profile height, parallelism as low as 10 microns, with a precision ball screw able to operate between 0 and 150 millimeters per second, and able to handle nearly 4,000 newton meters moment load with the LX45 and two long blocks selected. This next example, a three-axis MIG-Welding fixture, requires multi-axis assembly, high accuracy and repeatability, and operating at a medium speed where constant steady motion is key. With standard two-axis transition brackets available and configurable plates out of the MISUMI catalog, the LX can easily be installed in a multi-axis setup. The plus or minus 3 to 5 micron repeatability provides excellent positioning precision, while the standard rigid construction and preloaded ball screw allows for constant steady motion throughout the entire speed range, including a medium speed between 100 to 400 millimeters per second. In this vision inspection gantry, we once again are looking for a multi-axis installation with high accuracy and repeatability, and constant steady motion to ensure the product being inspected is always in view. Due to high volume of products being inspected, ensuring minimal downtime is a priority as well. Similar to the MIG welding fixture, the transition brackets, excellent repeatability, and standard rigid construction are all key features that help the LX succeed and the optional MX extended lubrication unit built into the actuator can be selected to reduce the frequency of maintenance and lubrication. This helps minimize the downtime and keeps the system running smooth. Finally, with this parts transfer or pick-and-place unit, a multi-axis installation with high accuracy and repeatability, simple and accurate alignment, and medium to high speeds are required. The high precision and repeatability provided by the LX, even up to the maximum speed range of around 1100 mm per second, provides outstanding positioning for precise timed motion, and with built-in dowel holes part of every LX actuator design, alignment and installation is simple and accurate. The last topic of this webinar will cover stepper motors, both open and closed loop, and servo motors. These are the most common electric motors used for precision positioning and are often the driving motors chosen for our LX precision positioning actuators. Stepper motors are widely used in a variety of positioning systems because of their small, compact size, low cost, and high torque output for the small size. Typical stepper motors can reach a maximum speed of up to 3,000 RPM and produce a much higher torque at lower speeds, with a holding torque when stationary to help maintain position when power is supplied. Stepper motors are usually open loop, with the internal structure of the motor allowing for the positioning functionality. This is ideal for quick short moves, providing fast response and rapid acceleration. Closed loop systems can be made by utilizing an encoder or resolver for position feedback, allowing for greater control. Servo motors are more expensive than stepper motors, but provide higher power output and higher speeds up to around 5,000 RPM. The torque speed curve is mostly flat as well, providing greater torque at higher speeds than stepper motors, and are all closed loop systems, using resolver or encoder feedback to position based on deviation. Both steppers and servos are excellent options to consider as drive units for the LX precision positioning actuators, as the rotary position resolution capable ranges from about 1.8 degrees down to fractions of a degree. This fine-tuned resolution, combined with the LX's fantastic accuracy and repeatability specifications, allow for an extremely precise linear motion system.
Thank you, and we hope you enjoyed today's webinar. All of MISUMI's configurable components and 1 million products are available at www.misumiusa.com. If you are new to MISUMI, register for access to CAD downloads, online formal quotes and orders, and manage all of your account histories. For first-time companies purchasing, you can receive 30% off. Full support is also available. Technical help at engineering@misumiusa.com, customer service at Inquire, and your local account manager at Sales. Facebook now has our 19-minute video series available to view at your leisure. Connect with us to join the conversation and see exclusive content. Thank you again.